Min karma and karma. There are two words, amma and karma.
Is there any difference?
Two languages. Two different languages. Pali and Sanskrit. Like Nibbana and Nirvana. Dhamma and Dharma. Pali and Sanskrit. Especially in Mahayana Buddhist countries, they follow the Sanskrit term, not the Pali term. But in Theravada countries like Sri Lanka, Thailand, Burma, they use Pali words, language spoken by the Buddha. Amma and Karma. This is one of the most difficult subjects to understand. I do not know whether you have heard, I have revealed this on many occasions. Friday talk, there are four things that we cannot understand clearly. We can spend our whole lifetime to study, but still we cannot understand clearly. Karma is one of them. Do you know what are those four things? Anybody who have heard earlier? There are four things. It is very, very difficult for us to get a clear picture. We have heard? No. No, Nibbana is not from that. Pardon? That's right, that is the first one. The Buddha. It's called Buddha Vishaya, nature of the Buddha. We create our own imagination, but we cannot understand what is enlightenment. And what is the next one? Jhana. What is jhana? What is the meaning of jhana? Ecstasy in English. Jhana, meaning of jhana, burning. Jhana. One who burns mental defilement, get some sort of psychic power. That power is called jhana, meaning of the word. Samatha, meditation, create this jhana. So after gaining this psychic power, they can perform certain supernatural, supernormal, miraculous power that people cannot understand how they do that. Second one. Third one? No, not belong to this group.
How karma works?
Karma is another one. It is difficult to understand the nature of karma. We believe, we know, but no clear understanding. What is the fourth one?
The nature of existence.
No. No. What? No. Try it. Because I want to know whether you have learned. And it is a very important point, you know. Forever we argue, discuss, but cannot come to a final conclusion because of our limited understanding capacity in our mind. Only after attaining sainthood, Sotapanna, Sakadagami, Anagami, Arahanta, Buddhavata, we can see only the superficial value of these things, but not clear understanding.
So,
no. Just as we mentioned about the Buddha. Loka, world, life and the world. There are a lot of problems that we cannot understand. These are the four things. In Pali language it is mentioned like that. Buddha Vishaya, Kamma Vishaya, Loka Vishaya, Jhana Vishaya. These four. We cannot understand. We study, do research work. Why it is difficult for us to understand the Buddha Vishaya? Vishaya means nature, nature of the Buddha. Buddha nature. That means enlightenment. We take this very loosely. Enlightenment means very deep understanding, philosophy, psychology, and sacredness, holiness, and we limit enlightenment by using our limited knowledge. But we have to go beyond that to understand so many unknown things. Then, karma vishaya, we use the word karma, but we do not know where it is, what it is, how it works. We do not know. Just believe. Then, example. Do you know the book, Milinda Panya, Milinda's questions, King Milinda and Nagadeva, dialogue. King Milinda asked this question, where this karma stored, deposited? He cannot understand. Then Nagasena said, it is difficult to see that karma is deposited or stored in particular area, in our body or in our mind. When the reaction or the effect, the result, good and bad result, we experience, then we come to know that is karmic effect. But we do know where this comes from. Then he has given a parable. So, a mango tree. We can see lot of flowers. After that we can see lot of roots. Those who cannot think deeply think these flowers and fruits come from the tree. These are deposited in the trunk of the tree, now coming out one by one. And that is how they think. A man who has never seen tree, who has come out from the jungle, first time he has seen a train. The engine is running. Then he asked, what is that? He said, this is train. Run, yes. Where is the horse? Without horse, how can this one run? Because he never knew there is anything in this world that can run without horse or bull. There must be somebody to pull this one. Where is the horse? By knowing his mentality, that man says, horse is inside the engine. He runs inside the engine, then this one runs. That's right. There must be horse. Otherwise, this one cannot run. This is our way of thinking earlier. So we have to learn, we have to develop our understanding capacity in our mind to know what these things are. Because Buddhism is not a religion for us to believe anything. There is nothing for us to believe. You know that. If you believe something not knowing, you are having wrong concept, wrong idea, wrong belief, because you have never studied. One day, a Christian priest came here with his followers, about 30 of them. We had a dialogue, very friendly talk. After that, the priest asked this question. Can you tell me what Buddhists believe? Then I told him very frankly, Buddhists do not believe anything. Then he has seen my book there in the cupboard. What Buddhists believe? He said, then why did you write that book? I said, that is why I wrote this book. You read this one, whether there is anything for them to believe? No, nothing. This is the nature of it. Then what is the Buddhist attitude? This is important for you to learn. Although we are talking about karma, as Buddhists, if anybody asks, actually what we are doing, can you tell me? Anybody who have learned this? Our duty. What we are doing as Buddhists. Cannot. Pariyatti, Patipatti, Pativeda. Three. They are three things. Pariyatti, study. Not to believe at once. First we must study. That is the first thing. Without studying, don't believe anything. Then the study. Then the second stage, after studying, practice. Without practicing, you can understand whether it is true or not. Practice. After practicing, you experience the result, the effect. Only these days. Let us take example. Can you remember those three names? Pariyatti, Patipatti, Pativeda. Meaning, first one, to study. First you must study. After that, you have wonderful knowledge, vast knowledge. That knowledge is useless if you do not practice. At a risk, take that knowledge. No use. If you do not practice, then practice. When you practice, then you will come to know that it is true, either good effect or bad. Take simple example. Now you study, when you practice kindness, to be kind, you extend your kindness to everybody, irrespective of race or color or religion or this or that, you extend your kindness, you learn that it is important, that is learned. After learning this, then you practice. You become very kind, not only to human beings, but to animals, birds. So when you extend this kindness toward those animals also, they become very friendly. They come nearer to us, slowly, slowly, slowly. Even the birds, you should never come to human beings. But you can see, birds go and sit on the cows and bulls and horses and elephants' back and go and digging and digging. But how many birds come and sit on our head? Because they don't trust us. They know we are very cruel. But when you extend this kindness, those birds and animals, wild animals also come near the earth. Because of that kindness. They smell. When the Buddha went to jungle and spent 3 months, no human beings there, who attended to the Buddha? The monkey and a wild elephant. This wild elephant, he boiled water also. Can you imagine how he boiled water? See how clever they are. First he find out whether there is any what you call pit where water accumulated. Then he bring 2 dry pieces of wood and dry leaves. Then go and rubbing and rubbing and rubbing and rubbing and rubbing and create fire. Then he bring a big stone and heat it. When stone is heated with the stick, he rolls, that the water becomes hot.
see how we go load for Buddha to take back.
They have mind to think. This time when I was in Indonesia, I got that photo also. One chimpanzee, he got one bucket, went to the pond, and bring one bucket of water, and started drinking like a man. He went very far to collect bucket of water and brought it and started drinking. They have mind. So, when we extend this kindness, then all the others also become very trained. Human beings also become very trained. Then they do not harm us, disturb us. Whenever their services are needed, they come and support us because of our kindness, reaction. That is the experience. Pariyatti, Patipatti, Pativeda. First we learn, after that practice, after practicing, we experience the good or bad results. Alright, let us come to the karma. What is the meaning of this word karma? Or karma? Meaning of the word. Pardon? No, simple means action. Simple means. Action, karma. When we do something, for that we say it is karma. Action. But when we come to religious area, now then we use wholesome, unwholesome. Good and bad, karmic. How many channels are there that we create karma in our life? How many channels are there? Six.
Three.
What are those three?
Mind,
speech, action. We create good karma and bad karma by using only our mind without doing anything. Only by talking without doing anything. Only by doing something. We create good karma and bad karma. Three channels. But the mind must be there. If you do certain things as our habit, without creating the idea that I want to do, it will never become karma. Understand? Good things and bad things. From the religious point of view, it never become karma. Because we never thought. Cetanaham bhikkhave kammam vadami. It is how the Buddha define the word. Cetana. Cetana means intention. Intentionally, we had to create the idea in our mind, we want to do this. After doing that, then it will become karma. Accidentally, we do a lot of good things and bad things. No karma. Motor car accident. You kill so many. Never become karma. Because you never create the idea in your mind that you want to kill all of you. That's why Chetana, thinking, very justifiable way, very reasonable way, the Buddha has explained this. Without our knowledge, we make a lot of mistakes. But those mistakes or good things never become karma from the religious point of view. You have to think. Then we talk. By talking we use harsh, wicked, cruel, vulgar words to hurt, disturb, accuse, blame others. First we have to create the idea in the mind. Those ideas turn into sound vibration. The mind is talking. First created by the mind, come out from the mouth, turn into sound vibration. The mind is responsible. Now then it will become heard. Now then action. We do something. Either eating, or beating, or shooting, or cutting, or killing, or destroying. We have to create the idea in the mind that we want to do that. Otherwise, you cannot do it. Stealing, bluffing, swindling, cheating, all these things. So, the first thing that we have to learn, without using our mind, we cannot create either good karma or bad karma. And whatever we create accidentally, without thinking that we want to do this, such things never become either good karma or bad karma. Unintentionally, so accidentally, or as habits. When you are used to do something as our habit, we don't think. Usually, we do that. Purposely, we have to create the idea in the mind. Then it will become karma. Then, karma divided into three. Wholesome, unwholesome, neutral. In simple language, good karma, bad karma, neutral karma. To do bad karma, you have to use either craving or hatred or illusion, so ignorance. Otherwise, we cannot create bad karma. There must be connection with our craving, with our anger, with our illusions or ignorance. Then it will become bad karma. To do good karma, mind must be free at that time from craving, hatred, and ignorance. By suppressing those evil forces, we do some good deed. Then it will become good karma. Example, you want to give dana. To give dana, first thing you have to reduce your craving. If you are greedy, you don't give anything to anybody. So you reduce your craving. Then, if you are angry with them, if you have anger in your mind, you never give anything for them. So anger also not functioning, working at that time in the mind. If you are ignorant, you never do that because you think it is useless, wasting your thing. You must have understanding why we should give. Then there is no ignorance. So the mind is free from these three things. The good things that you have done with good intention. So it will become good karma. Now in between, there are so many things, so many karma. They are neutral. Neutral means never develop this either evil thoughts or good thoughts. We do so many things for our living, for our pleasure, for our convenience, but they have nothing to do with this good karma or bad karma. Now, early morning you go to market for marketing, buying vegetables, fish and fruits. You go there, it is karma. You can buy and bring them, it is karma. You cut and cook, it is karma. You eat, it is karma. But you have never created either good karma or bad karma. Neutral. So, we spend most of our time for this kind of neutral karma. You go to office early morning, it is karma. You go and work there, it is karma. You get salary, it is karma for your living, for your survival. Nothing to do with good karma or bad karma. Now see the difference. That means the mind is responsible for that. A German Buddhist scholar, Dr. Paul Dahlke, he has given a very simple parable for us to understand how the mind can create good karma or bad karma by turning the mind either this side or that side to do the same thing. Action is the same, but the mind can turn either this way or that way. Example he has given like this. Now you bring a cup of honey. To protect Golokhava, to protect this honey, what you do, you bring another source and pour some water and keep this here. Now the ants cannot come, cannot disturb your honey. That is the idea, isn't it? So your idea is to protect your honey. That's all. But the same action we can turn into a good karma by thinking another way. How? Can you tell me? Cannot. I keep this honey in this way to protect those poor ants who come and drop into the cup to avoid, prevent, because so many die in the honey. So my idea is to protect the ants, not to protect the honey. See, the mind can turn this way and that way, then it will become good karma. Because you develop your kindness towards, they are also living beings. That is the nature of karma. How we use our mind to do something. Then, just now I told you, whatever we do unintentionally, without thinking, without creating idea in our mind, we want to do this. That cannot create a karma for us to experience either good result or bad result, because the mind cannot maintain the mental impulses, mental waves, mental energy to maintain it, because it is not implanted, created in the mind, only action. But worldly conditions can create the bad effect of good, but nothing to do with karma. Example, when you drive your motor car, accidentally you knock a man a child or die on the spot. Although you did not create any bad karma, you get into trouble. According to the law, existing law of the country also, you get into trouble. If not, that person, relatives, friends, they come and attack you, beat you, kill you, burn your motor car also. But nothing to do with karma. That is the worldly condition. We experience lot of problems and we also gain lot of favoritism in this. Accidentally we do certain things, but we have to face the difficult consequences. We have to face the outcome of it. That has nothing to do with religion. Then, another important point. Now we accumulate good karma and bad karma during our lifetime. All mix up. Certain karma create the effect within this lifetime while we are living here. Only certain karma. Certain karma create the effect only hereafter. After our death, in the next life, not earlier. If no effect, either within this lifetime or in the next life, all those karmas disappear, evaporate, extinct. Because no strength, no what you call energy to continue, follow us. And certain karma, there is no time limit. As long as we exist in this wheel of existence, life after life, life after life, these karmas also follow us just like our shadow, waiting for a chance. When the chances arise, then either good one or bad. This is what many people have understood. Now, there are so many culprits, terrorists, gangsters, drug traffickers, murderers, who endanger the whole country. But they enjoy their life. People love this question. They do lot of bad things by killing and stealing and disturbing. No karma for them. They enjoy their life. And that is what I told you. For us to understand, it is difficult to understand. And easiest way to understand this is, now let us take, I think nearly 1 year ago, one man called Kalimuttu. He killed 17 innocent people. Kalimuttu. So one day he was caught and finished. Many years ago, I think nearly 20 to 25 years ago, there was another dangerous man, Botachi. He was caught, sentenced to death, and he donated his eyes also before his death. He pledged to donate eyes. He was caught. In Colombia, the king, even the government also assuring he's so powerful. He has shaken the government over. But finally he was shot dead. That means those who commit bad karma can escape from the punishment, or not punishment actually, bad effect, bad result. Because they have certain good supportive karma. What they have done during their previous birth to protect, support. When that supportive karma is weakened, after that, they will be caught. For that, I can give a simple example. In our physical body, we have a resistance of antibodies. Antibodies are very active. Germs, virus, bacteria that enter into our body cannot create sicknesses because antibody fight and kill them. Cannot create. But there are some others, a little bit of wind or rain or heat, next day sick. Because no resistance, no antibodies are not active, cannot protect. Exactly. Although we are doing lot of bad things, if our supportive karmas are active or strong, these bad karmas have no chance to come and catch. Now we can understand. Many people complain. They enjoy their life. We are doing lot of good work, but we are suffering. They enjoy. Then another problem. You are very kind, very honest, very cooperative. You never harm anybody. You try to lead a very peaceful religious life. But for nothing, you get into trouble. A lot of problems. Then you start to grumble. We have never done any harm to anybody. We never disturb anybody. Why we get into trouble? This is another excuse. So there's no point of doing good things. We also must follow others. It is like this. Now you drive your motor car very, very carefully to avoid accident. Very carefully you drive. But without knowledge, somebody comes here and bang! Then you start to think, what is the big idea of taking precautions to avoid accidents? In future, I am also going to drive like this. What is that? You must understand the nature of worldly condition, situation. Although we are good, if others are not good, then we get it. We are good when others are good. When others are bad, we also become bad. Example. Now you have smiling face, very serene, very nice, very charming. If I use few dirty, wicked, vulgar words, you can see your sour face. Understand? When others are bad, you have no chance to maintain your peace, your happiness, your calmness, your gentleness, your charm. That's why religion is important here. In spite of all these disturbances, you must have courage and knowledge to maintain. So, just now I told you, there are three periods for us to experience the karmic effect. Within this lifetime, or after our death in the next life, or any time as long as we exist in this samsara. What is the reason? Have you learned anybody? Is there any reason for you to be? Why it is like this? The psychological problem. Not ordinary psychology, Buddhist psychology. What is the Pali word for Buddhist psychology? You also do not know. MC also doesn't know. What is the Pali word for Buddhist psychology? Abhidhamma. Abhidhamma means analytical interpretation of the human mind as matters. That is called Abhidhamma. Only religion in this world that analyzes and explains the nature of human mind. No any other religion. Others say you must believe and practice and follow. They do not know anything about human mind. So, do you know, to do something, our mental beats, mental impulse must work how many times? 7 times. 17 in another line. This year, 7. We do our good or bad action in one, during one of these beats, like this. Always going, beating, like this. Like this. The mind is like that. Mental waves, 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 waves. So, first beat, when the mind starts to beat, at the first beat, we do something, either good or bad. That action, that karma, is not very heavy. Why? Suddenly appeared in the mind, suddenly we have taken action. Without allowing the mind to go on thinking and thinking and thinking and thinking. Existing law in any country, very close to this. What is that? Now, suddenly you get angry, you kill a man. Earlier you never had the idea to kill him. You could not control your anger, suddenly you killed. When the judge, justice, come to know this, after listening, hearing, he never sentenced him. That is called culpable homicide. Because you never planned, sentenced to jail, no death. Exactly like this. See, really how religion explains. Suddenly idea appear in your mind, immediately you have taken action, and the effect, the result, cannot carry for long period. Because the mind cannot carry this for a long period. And the effect or the result within this life. After our death, nothing. If no result, no effect within this lifetime due to certain other karma, this thing, you are today. So although we have done certain bad karmas like this, by doing more and more heavy good karma, we can topple this kind of karma because they have no chance. Next one. Why the effect comes to us only in the next life? I told you 7 times. If the action is done at the 7th beat, last beat, and no continuation from there. 7th one is the last one. and that turn also weak. But gone through all the stages, therefore stronger than the first turn. So we can carry, it is not that we carry, they follow us. The effect follow us up to the next life, next birth, only up to next year. If there are no some other strong good or bad karma, then only that karma affects us.
These two have come to five. Now if you do any good karma or bad karma within these, because they have gone this way and this way and this way and that way, done lot of mental pollution if it is bad karma. Done lot of purities in the mind, mental purification if they are good karma. Then the karmic effect lasts long period and follow us like shadow. Never disappear easily. You understand? These are the points that many people cannot understand. Not easy to disappear, follow us. Wherever rebirth takes place, this karma also follows. Now, the Buddha, do you know, he had to suffer from 12 kinds of sicknesses. That is the last birth, final birth. Then he explained to his disciples, do you know why I am suffering from these sicknesses? That means a long, long ago, I don't know how many thousands of millions of years, he had committed certain bad karma. And those bad karma, hidden karma, still following. Then explain these are the effects. The Buddha was not free. How many arahants, these disciples were murdered by others? Then the Buddha explained, do you know why he had to die like this? During one of his previous Vatamanta Moggallan, the chief disciple of the Buddha, he had to die. He was killed. That is the nature of karma. No one is free from karma. Now, we are innocent. We don't do any harm to anybody. We are very honest. But we get into trouble for nothing. We blame. The reason is, although we are good in this lifetime, we do not know what we have done during our previous life. Certain hidden bad karma were waiting, had the opportunity to create it up. So we are responsible. Don't blame, don't accuse others. They are responsible for our problems, for our unknown karma. Because there is nobody to relieve. On the other hand, those who are suffering, those who are very poor, live very unfortunate, miserable life, suddenly they go forward and they get wonderful, good results and wonderful life and pleasurable, certain hidden good karma have come forward and that's why I told you, it's a very difficult thing to understand how this karma create the effect. Then, the biggest problem is where this karma is deposited. Abhidharma says karma is not deposited anywhere in our mind or body. Conditions, worldly condition, environment create the effect, and the karma is just like gravity and cosmic energy. Condition, situation combined together. Then the reaction, so the effect, we experience. That is what we can understand. How these karmic effects. But modern psychology explains something. Our subconscious mind. After gaining his enlightenment, the first word came out from the Buddha's mouth. Aneka jati sansaran. Visankara gatan kittan. Kittam is mind. Visankara means no more sankara. What is sankara? The thought which creates good and bad habits. Sankara. Now we have this. In our mind we have the thoughts which can create either good karma or bad karma at any time. But the Buddha says, now I have no such thought, sankhara in my mind. He cannot create good karma. He cannot create bad. Then you can ask why he cannot create good karma. He does lot of good things. Why? Can you give me the answer? Why the Buddhas and Arahantas cannot create good karma? Bad karma, of course, we can understand. Because they have no anger, no craving, no jealousy, no ignorance. Therefore, they cannot create bad karma. Why they cannot create good karma?
No more rebirth.
No more rebirth. Yes, Mr. Paul? Chetana. They have Chetana. I can give an example. We cannot create either good karma or bad karma if there is no craving in our mind. Do you know that? To do good karma also, you must have craving. Why? By giving dana, you want to be born in a rich family to enjoy your life. You want to go to heaven to play mahjong there to enjoy your life. Craving is there. You do a lot of good karma because of your craving. And craving for bad thing, of course, you can understand. So, Arahantas and Buddhas have no such craving in their mind. So, whatever good deeds that they do or perform never become karma because no craving. Without craving, we cannot create karma. This example I have given on many occasions. A man who was sleeping under a mango tree at night time, he came and slept under a mango tree. It is in somebody else's land, not his own. Covering his completely like this and sleep. So when he was sleeping at midnight, he heard sound, something drop. Because all the five senses are also sleeping when they sleep. Because of that sound, this channel is open. He heard the sound. Now he was started to work, connected, switch on to the mind. He wanted to know what it is. He got up and went on searching, channel, open another channel, switch on the other channel, other line. And he went on searching, he saw something there. Went and opened another channel, feeling. Three channels are working with the mind now. Still he doesn't know what it is. Then, smell. Open another channel. Nice smell. Still not sure whether eatable or not. Then, ate. Very sweet. Ate. All the five channels are open. Then develop craving. After eating only he develop craving. Earlier there was no craving. The sweetness created craving. Then eat a very sweet mango. Not belong to him. Then he thought, why not I climb and churi pluck some mango and go home. Created bad karma. How craving can create karma? Without craving we cannot create karma. So the good karma also I told you, go to heaven to enjoy life, to be rich and this and that, to long life and prosperity, all based on craving. So, this is the nature of karma. For good karma as well as bad karma, there must be craving. So the modern psychology. You know Dr. Edgar Cayce in America. You have heard about it. It's a very interesting case. He had a very peculiar sickness. Consulted so many doctors. No cure. Incurable doctors. But he did not give up hope. What he did? He developed his psychic power, like getting to trance. Develop. Now he can penetrate into subconscious mind. Like hypnotism. You know, when we hypnotize a person, that person can speak entire different language that he or she never learned within his lifetime, during the previous birth. And give the names and information of all the details in the previous birth, where he or she was, and which family, fathers, mothers, brothers, sisters, all the details through hypnotism. There's no argument about that. So, this doctor, he developed this. He discovered a medicine to cure his own sickness. Because in our subconscious mind, it is called storehouse of consciousness. Everything what we have learned, life after life, a store. Languages, knowledge, science, religion, and wonderful knowledge. But everything submerged, sunk. That is why we cannot use it. The normal mind is working with the five senses. Therefore, subconscious mind cannot influence. When we sleep, the five senses are not dealing with the mind. The mind is alone. That is why, at that time, subconscious mind projects focus. We get dreams. Dreams appear because of the subconscious mind. So, in amongst those dreams that we experience, some are very, very meaningful, not useful. Indicate something, give warning, give some information for our protection, precaution for our future. Come from the subconscious mind, karmic influence. Come from the deva, influence the mind, who have relationship during the previous birth. When the mind is weak, working with the five senses, they cannot reach. They dial and dial your line language. So they know how to dial when you sleep. Catch. Devas, and especially our departed relatives who are in the spirit form as good devas, they communicate because mental relationships still work, although physically separated. So, subconscious mind, when we learn how to reach, we can find out so many things. The gold mine and the dustbin also. All good and bad, what we have done. So this Edgar Cayce cured his sicknesses. When this news spread, more and more people started coming. That institute is still open in America, Virginia. His son is there, but he's a clever man. The book, in the record book, it is mentioned he has attended 20,000 people. So when he gets into trance, what he says, I'm sorry, it is impossible to cure your sickness. Because this is the bad effect of the wicked or cruel or bad deeds that you have done during your last birth. He was not a Buddhist. He doesn't know anything about rebirth. He doesn't know anything about karma. But when he gets into trance, he says like this. When he is normal, he doesn't believe that he has it like this. Because the subconscious mind is talking. To some others, he says, he gets into trance, yes, can cure. Now then, he prescribes certain medicines. Okay. Now these are very accurate, very genuine cases. There are books written by research workers, what he has done. Now that is karma. So in our case, we do not know what is karma. When so many disciples, monks and nuns and devotees were affected, they are innocent people. Then the Buddha said, do you know why this person had to suffer like this? Why this person had to die earlier? During one of his previous births, he or she had done this. That's that karma follow and waiting. Then, another important point. Forgiveness of sins or karma. Sins mean karma. Now, other religions talk about forgiveness of sins. God can forgive your sins. We never believe this because it is impossible. In the Buddha's teaching, it is mentioned, Suddhi Asuddhi Pachyattam Nanya Manya Visode in Dhammapada. He said, mental purity, mental impurity. Nanya Manya Visode. Another person cannot create, another person cannot wipe out. That means outsiders cannot intervene. God or Buddha, Buddha also cannot. God or Buddha or another person cannot touch that karma. They cannot do anything for it. Therefore, we cannot believe that God can remove or wash away the sin. It is imagination. But the Buddha taught us how to wipe out the sins or the bad karma committed by us. Another person cannot do that. You can ask the Buddha, he cannot do that. It is against the nature. Just like changing the gravity. It doesn't work. He says, assume you have done some bad karma earlier. Later, you realize it. You have been doing some bad karma. You know it is wrong. Now then, instead of worshipping, praying, offering, chanting, and sacrificing all these things to this God, that God, and this and that, you cannot get rid of that. First thing, you have to stop all the bad deeds that you have been doing. That is the first stage. Right, now we have stopped. Second stage, you have to do more and more and more and good karma. Good karma. Third stage, you have to reduce your selfishness, your anger, your hatred, your ill will, evil thoughts from the mind. Then the bad karma becomes weaker. These actions and thoughts and karmas become more powerful. So after your death, you get the chance to be born in a better condition because this fresh karma, new karma, heavy karma that you have accumulated later supports you. But all the other bad karmas are still in the waiting list. Never disappear. You cannot wipe out. But they have no chance to reach you. You have developed more and more and more good karma. Let us take Angulimala, who has killed more than 1,000 humans. Then the Buddha approached him. He tried to kill the Buddha also, but he could not reach, catch the Buddha. Then he knew there was something. They had a dialogue. Then he decided to follow the Buddha. Became a monk. Then, by following a religious way of life, meditation, he attained arahanta. He became an arahanta, the number one murderer. Became an arahanta. You know, after attaining arahanta, no more evil. Now, this bad karma he has committed cannot follow. There must be rebirth for this karma to follow an effect. So the karma, bad karma can follow up to the gate of the Nirvana. When he enter into Nirvana, bad karma all disappears. See the technique introduced by you. Use your common sense. You can understand which is more practical, meaningful, useful. Simply by go and pray and worship and I offer you one kingdom milk and three just take and please take away all my sin. Oh, I believe in you and this and that. Or stop all the bad deeds, do more and more good deeds, reduce your evil thoughts from the mind, which is more useful. That is the Buddhist thing. Then you are the one who can forgive your sin. Nobody else can forgive. Lord also cannot, Buddha also cannot. This is the nature of karma. Coming to 5:30, you started what time? About 4 something, isn't it? There are so many things to talk about karma. Then, there are 10 kinds of karma introduced by the Buddha as heavy karma. Certain karmas only by the mind. Certain karmas only by the word. Certain karmas by the body. Three channels. Panadhata, Paradabha, Paradhar. These three. Committed by using our body, physical body. Killing, stealing, sexual misconduct. Body, by using the body, we create these three bad karma. Killing, stealing, sexual misconduct. Now then, Musa, Pesunya, Parusa, Sampappalapa. Vachata, by word. By talking, we create four bad karma. Telling lies, Musa. Pesunya. What is pesunya? Slandering. You know what is slandering? Backbiting. Parusa? Harsh, wicked, vulgar. Word that we use to hurt. Sampappala. Frivolous talk, rubbish. This talk, rubbish, no meaning at all. Wasting time. Fourthing. By talking, that is how we have to guard our tongue when we talk. And then, mind itself can create certain karma. Very few. Otherwise, simply by thinking, we cannot create karma. Either we must say something or we must do something. But here there are three. Simply by thinking, we can create bad karma. Avidya, Vyapada, Mityadhyaya. What is Avidya? Not Avidya. Avidya is one thing. This is Avidya. A-B-H-I. Avidya. What is Avidya? Covetousness. Covetousness means poisonous craving. In simple language. Not ordinary craving. Poisonous craving. Then I give you an example, then you can understand. Your father is very rich, but still he is very strong. And you think, how nice if he die, I can enjoy all this of it. That kind of way. That's why it's called poison. It's a very dangerous place. Not ordinary place. To get others' property by praying for their destruction or death. Thinking, how nice if they die, I can take. Very dangerous place. Only by thinking we create this bad karma. Next one. Vyapada. What is Vyapada? What? Ill will. English word is ill will. There are few words. Anger, hatred, grudge, ill will. Same line. Anger is emotion. This anger we can become positive or negative. Emotion. Human emotion. When emotion turn into positive side, we laugh and joke and enjoy. That is the positive side of the emotion. When that emotion turns into negative side, we cry, we worry. And this is the nature of emotion. When this emotion arouses, when a person has no courage to control that emotion, anxiety, then if he is impatient, that emotion turn into anger. Then anger flare up like fire. That is emotion. Then shout, scold, beat. That is emotion. Craving, anxiety, impatience are behind. Then mental pollution takes place because of it. Later, this anger develops further. Turn into hatred. Hate. That is why some people say, I hate that man. I hate this. That anger develops further. Then it will become hatred. After keeping this in the mind, it will become grudge. Waiting to take revenge. Started from anger. Created enmity. Waiting to take revenge. Grudge. Then here is what ill will. Ill will means waiting to see the downfall of that person. When something happened to that person, your enemy, motor car accident and this and then you say, oh wonderful, I knew. You enjoy. Yes, that person who died is your enemy. Ill will. Waiting to see the downfall of that. This thought itself creates bad karma. It is called avijja. Then, last one is mithyadikti. Wrong concepts, wrong beliefs, wrong ideas. Wrong ideas create bad karma. It is mentioned 10 kinds of wrong concepts or wrong ideas. Natti dinnan, natti ittan, natti utan, natti sukata dukkatan, kammanan, palan, vipako. Natti ayam loko, natti paraloko, natti mata, natti pita, natti loke, samana, brahmana, samadhata, paripanna. Many people have some of these wrong. Natti dinna. Why should we give? Charity or contribution or dana, why should we give? Not necessary. That belief. Should not give anything to anybody. Let them work and find out their own way. By giving, we won't gain anything in return. There are some people. Not stinginess, but they don't believe that. That is important. Natthi sukata dukkatan kammanan palan upa. Good actions never create good results. Bad actions never create bad results. That means good karma and bad karma. That's nothing. We can do anything whatever we like. Then we believe. Natti ayam loko, natti paraloko. Those who believe that this is the only life. We never existed earlier before we come to this world. And there won't be another life after our death. We is the first and this is the last. That belief. Therefore nothing to worry about. So many people try to keep away from bad things by thinking the next life. Do a lot lot of good things also by thinking the next time. So those who do not believe, they can do anything whatever. So this is called Vichara, wrong. Natthi ayam loko natthi. Natthi mata natthi pita. Father and mother. Why should we support father and mother? Why should we respect them? Leave them alone. You are not responsible. Just shun, ignore, neglect. Animals, parents look after their young ones when they were very small. They fight to protect their young ones, but when they grow up, when they can stand their own feet, okay, you let them up. So their parents never expect anything from their children. There's no such system. But humans, father and mother, spend all their life, sacrifice their whole life, their children, thinking that when they are old, trouble, or they are sick, our children can't support them. So if children neglect this, from the human point of view, it is wrong, it is bad. It is bad karma from the material point of view. They neglect others. Not to respect them, not to support them. Natthi mata natthi. Natthi loke samna brahmana samadgata patta. There are no such people, religious people, holy people in this world. All are human beings. And why should we, when respect and worship to some people thinking they are religious or holy, why should we go and offer food and eat and that? Not necessary. Leave them alone. That belief. Natthi satta opapat. Now this is a very difficult thing to understand. Opapatika means a spontaneous birth. A spontaneous means life come into existence without giving birth by mother. How many places are there like that? Lot. Can you mention some of them? We have no experience about that. There are many. Can you mention one place? Females never give birth. But life come into existence in many places. Huh? That's right, Deva. Another place? Brahma, right? Another place? No. Hell. Hell. A spirit. Ghost. No, they are females. Never give birth. How lucky they are. They are free from all these problems. This is called spontaneous birth. They are karma. Karmic energy is such. The life process, mental energy, cosmic energy, elements are combined together with their magnetic power and the life come into existence. And no babies, and no old men or old women. They exist as they appear for a long period. No old age, no baby. After that, disappear. When they disappear, no corpse, no dead body. Because the combinations of elements, not like ours. Now this is the nature of Deva, Brahma, Earth Spirit, Ghost, Devils, their life. So they come into existence without giving birth by the female or the mother. You say, oh, we don't believe that. It is a wrong belief. But I cannot agree. If we cannot understand, how can we believe it? I don't think it's advisable to add this item into this. Understand? We just now, I also cannot understand. I believe because I am forced to believe. Otherwise, I will go to hell if I don't believe that. That's not just a favor. There are certain things that we cannot understand unless we develop our mind into certain areas. So I believe that they have added this item in the wrong place to show as it is a very bad karma. If you don't believe that there is no such a life, it can become a bad karma. But I don't know. And it should be anything. Whether we can believe or not, we should not reject. Now that is the best advice given by God. He said, you should neither accept anything at once, nor reject. The best advice. Don't believe anything at all. No, you get it right. Because of emotional feeling, using the very limited knowledge, we think, yes, it is right. So we have to don't. At the same time, he said, don't reject. Don't say, no, no, we don't believe that. Give time. Think. Observe. Study. Investigate. Later, you will come to know whether to accept or to reject. It's a wonderful advice. So we can include this into that category. Although we cannot understand, but we should not reject. Oh, how can be that? There won't be such life. Now, rubbish. Don't say like this. So, these are the 10 kinds of bad karma that we commit by using our mind, our words, our mind. On the other hand, 10 kinds of meritorious deeds, good karma. Dānaṁ, sīlaṁ, bhāvanā, patti, pattānumodana, veyyāvaccha, apachāyana, desana, sutti, ditti. 10 kinds of good karma. Easy to understand. Dāna. Dāna is not charity. Charity means that we contribute something with sympathetic feeling. Needs. That is called charity. So the meaning of dāna is different. To give dāna, we have to reduce, as I mentioned earlier, our craving, our anger, our ignorance. To reduce these evil forces, we practice, we call generosity. We sacrifice something for the benefit of others. Others are benefited, but we are also benefited by reducing our evil forces. That's called that. Sila. Sila means, what is the meaning of sila? That is very loose word, that is morality. Without any religion also, we can say morality. What is the real meaning of this word, sila? You say sikha padang samadhyami. What does it mean of sikha padang? Train. Abstain to train ourselves. Now that is the real meaning of sila. We keep away from certain things to train ourselves. Now, we don't want to kill and destroy or harm others. We abstain. Then we train ourselves to develop kindness, compassion, understanding, and unity and harmony, all the good qualities in this mind. Now that is called sila. So, there are so many sealers for us to observe, to train ourselves, to be good. Dānaṁ sīlaṁ. Bhāvanā. What is the meaning of bhāvanā? Meaning of this word bhāvanā? Yes, not mindfulness also. Mental culture, mental development. Real meaning of bhāvanā. Mental development. We say meditation. The purpose is to cultivate, to develop the mind. Because the mind are very big. Very big, very, what do you call, yes, mind is always polluted. Mental pollution create a lot of disturbance. So meditation is to reduce the toxics from the mind, dirt from the mind, and to cleanse the mind. Then strengthen the mind. That is called the power. Dānaṁ sīlaṁ power. Patti. Patti means transference of merits. That is very important. We transfer the merits only to our departments. We cannot transfer the merits to living departments. We cannot transfer the merits to unknown people. There must be mental communication, relationship. Because unknown people cannot catch the wavelengths, cannot attune the catch the wavelengths. Now somebody dies from our family, and that person has mental communication with us. When we radiate by transferring marriage to our mother or father or brother or anybody, because of that communication they get it. Outsiders cannot get it. So transference of marriage. Very important for them, because they can get rid of that unfortunate state, have a bit rebirth again, continue the journey. They are standard. Then, pattanumodana, that one. Appreciations of others, good work. Now people come and tell you, today I have done this and this. Oh, wonderful, remarkable. We really appreciate. You also get the share. If he says to me, you wasted your money for nothing, you will wear it. So you must know how to appreciate others' good work, encouraging them to carry on. Sharing, it goes sharing of them. We share, appreciate. Sharing means appreciating. veya vacha. Cleaning, washing, polishing, and maintaining cleanliness in a place where people use for their religious or educational or some other useful purposes. Maintain cleanliness by cleaning, polishing. It is a meritorious thing. When you come to the temple, do some dirt and rubbish and this and that, clean nicely. It is a meritorious thing. Then, upper child, respect those who are worthy of respect. Irrespective of religion, whether they are Christians or Hindus or Muslims or those who have no religion, it is not the important part. If you think they are worthy of respect, that is Buddhism. Because among the followers of all the other religions, also there are very good people, very virtuous people who are worthy of respect. So by respecting them, we encourage them to carry on, maintain their noble religious services. It is a mentor. Or some people say, oh, sorry, I cannot worship you, I cannot respect you, I am a Buddhist. And that is wrong. When I visit church and when I meet archbishop and all those people, we greet each other like this. It is oriental. It's not worshipping. This is greeting. Greeting is this, worshipping is like this. That is called worshipping. Two things. Then, Vijayavacha Tapataya. Ministering. Ministering means becoming a minister, isn't it? Huh? No. Then what is it? Ministering. Not become a minister. Ministering means helping, supporting, assisting, especially elders, sick people, parents. There are many things that we can do: washing, cleaning, bathing, changing, feeding. Ministering. Very highly appreciated. That's all. Yeah. Desana. What do you mean, desana? Desana means preaching. And now I am doing. I gain the merits by teaching, preaching, telling, becoming meaningful words for you to learn to be good. So I gain a lot of merits by preaching. Suti, listen, you also gain the merits. Because you control your mind, you concentrate, you don't allow evil, wicked thoughts to come and occupy the mind. Some sort of purity you maintain in your mind when you listen. Enrich your knowledge and understanding, devotion, confidence. So you get the right. Ditti Yu, the last one. Straighten the doubts and certain weaknesses you had in your mind after listening. Formerly you say, well, I did not believe this earlier. Now I realize it. If not, certain doubts you had in your mind, clarify. Clearance. So the more you listen, the more you read, the more you straighten your mind. Then confidence. You develop your confidence. Now these are the 10 kinds of karma explained. There are so many other things we can talk for hours about karma. Anyway, today I think it's enough. I shouldn't overload you. Okay?
Wow, getting more and more people.
Hmm? Love that one.
So I think, yeah, we have 5 minutes more to six.
5 minutes more?
To six. Yeah, any question, any questions? Yeah,
that's right. Spend about 5 minutes for questions.
Any questions, and it's important to clarify our doubts.
Although you observe these 5 precepts within this lifetime, you do not know what sort of karmas you have accumulated during the previous life. Until you attain the first stage of saint to Sotapanna, you never get the guaranteed certificates. That never become animal or ghost or devils or hell or anything. Below that level, there is no guarantee. Because the mind is changing. Circumstances can change mind. Only after attaining Sotapanna, the first stage, no one can change the confidence that development. After that can say you never become, or never hold wrong concept, wrong belief, wrong idea, after changing. But at this moment, although you learn a lot of dharma, others can influence you to change your mind. Now, this is the nature of our mind.
Ravindra Bhattacharya,
thing?
Sometimes you do the karma, but the person who takes the karma, the entity of the karma, will not benefit in the way that he can. That's the end effect. There's a benefit at all.
I cannot understand it. It isn't
clear.
Really.
Let's say you help somebody who's drunk, right?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
But actually, you're not helping him at all. You're just encouraging him to come
to no, no. Unless you create idea in your mind that you want to encourage. You understand? Your idea is supporting him to get rid of his problem. Then you never create any bad karma. If you create idea, I must support him more for him to drink more and more, then you add it. Like eating fish and meat. Some people say it is wrong. You encourage. Yes. While eating, if you think I eat more and more for them to slaughter more and more, then you add it. Unless you create that idea in your mind, you cannot create any bad karma. Mind is responsible for that. Okay? Yeah, they are called Javana Chitta in the Pali language. Javana means running. Javana Chitta means running mind. In English, it's a mental impulse or mental beat in simple language. Without that mental beat, that mental impulse, we cannot do anything to become either good karma or bad karma. Otherwise, it can easily become neutral. There must be either craving or hatred or ill will get involved with that mental beat. You understand?
Seven.
It, because like waves, you know. When the waves go up, again goes down, pushing the water again. The continuity is there. Exactly like this.
Arahant see all these changes that fast.
What sort of
thing? I mean the seven,
the way there are two kinds of arahants. Those who have developed samatha meditation and those who have developed vipassana meditation. Through vipassana, realizations appear, eradicate mental defilement, attain arahant, purity, perfection. But they have no supernormal power, no only purity and perfection. Those who have developed samatha meditation attain jhana stage and later, in the last moment, change into vipassana, otherwise no nirvana. And they maintain that power because they have developed psychic power through this jhana stage. Now they are the ones who can perform miracles, supernatural, supernormal power to go to heaven. And Mughalana used to go to heaven and come back and tell others, I met your uncle, you know, we had done the video, I met your auntie, you know. Then again he go to hell and come back and, you know, I met your father who has slaughtered every day, he's suffering there. Because of this, more and more people come and embrace Buddhism. So the followers, other religion lost their followers. They thought this is a real nuisance to us. They got hold of some gangsters and gave some money and asked to go and slaughter, to kill Mughalana because of that. Even this religious competition was very keen even at that time. Mughalana had to die because of that earlier. Then the Buddha explained to the disciples, do you know why? Because during one of his previous births, his father and mother both were blind. He was attending to them very, very carefully. He didn't want to get married because of blind parents. But the parents forced him to get married. They will die very soon. You have to leave the life. You must find out why. Otherwise, you cannot lead a very happy, holy life. Because of them, he had to find out a way. And this wife, every day, for these blind people, dirty the house, he had to clean and wash and this and that. After some time, his wife said, anyway, if we are not going to get rid of this poor couple, I'll go back to my house. Every day, nagging and nagging and nagging. Now, this poor young man was thinking, what to do? He planned such a way. He said, now we are very poor. I know you have given a lot of money to so-and-so, 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 they have no return. Why not we go there, ask them to return? The long journey through the jungle. They agreed. They had a bullock cart to go through the jungle. So they knew, the old couple, in this jungle there are a lot of thieves who attack people and take you with their valuables. He took the advantage of this. On the way, he stuck the bullock cart. Say, now thieves are coming. Because they are blind, they cannot see. Then start beating. He is beating. Then these thieves come and beat. Finally, when he was beating to father and mother, they said, please, you must escape. must escape and run it. See how they are kindness. And this man, he dropped father and mother in the jungle and tied them to a tree and come back. They died in the jungle. The Buddha said, this is the effect of that karma he has done. He has created. So one day, a few years ago, when I was taking breakfast, the feeling was empty at that time, I saw an old lady